एप्सिलॉन क्लोजर फॉर ईच ऑफ दिस गिवन स्टेट्स, राइट? सो एप्सिलॉन क्लोजर 0, इट विल गिव अस 0 इटसेल्फ एंड 7, ओके, डेफिनेटली 1 फ्रॉम दिस साइड, 2 एंड 3, राइट? सॉरी सॉरी, 2 एंड 4, ओके, देन एप्सिलॉन क्लोजर ऑफ स्टेट, सॉरी, एप्सिलॉन क्लोजर ऑफ स्टेट 1 कम्स, सो इट विल बी 1 इटसेल्फ, 2 एंड 4, ओके, देन एप्सिलॉन क्लोजर ऑफ 2, From 2, by giving epsilon, we can just stay to 2 only, right? Then epsilon closure of 3, if you see, you can go stay on the 3 itself, then you can go to 6, you can go to 7 also, then from 6 you can come to 1, from 1 to 2 and 2 and 1 to 4 also. Then epsilon closure of 4, if you see, it is only 4. Okay. Then epsilon closure of 5, if you see, it is going to be 5 itself. From 5 you can go to 6. From 6 you can go to 7. From 6 you can go to 1 also. And from 1 you can go to 2. And from 1 you can go to 4 also. Okay, then epsilon closure of 6, if you see, from 6 you can stay on 6, you can go to 7, you can go to 1, from 1 you can go to 2 and 4 both. Then epsilon closure of 7 is equal to 7 itself. Is there any other path? No. An epsilon closure of 8, without giving anything from 8, you can go nowhere, you can stay only on 8. Then epsilon closure of 9 is only 9, and epsilon closure of 10 is equal to 10 only. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to generate a transition table. Okay, we have to generate a transition table for our DFA, what we want to construct. Okay, so in the DFA, we will have move for A and move for B. Okay, so what will be our initial state? Initial state will be the epsilon closure of 0. Okay, so epsilon closure of 0, if you see, it is 0 itself, 1, 2, 4, right? So we arrange it properly. We write here 0, 1, then we write 2, then we write 4. Okay, and 7 also. We have this path, we have this path also, no? So you can go to 7 also. Okay, so 4 and 7. Okay, we give this set a name A. Okay, so we have to find out delta capital A comma A. Okay, so how we will understand what will be the transition or what will be the destination by giving this? We have to see first, this is A. Out of the states which are having some transition for A, 0, there is no transition for A. On 1, there is no transition for A. For 2, there is a transition for A, which leads you to 3. And for 4, there is no transition for A, but for 7, you have transition for A, which leads you to 7. Sorry, leads you to 8, right? This one you have, and this one you have. Okay, so it can be written like this: delta 2 comma A union delta 7 comma A. And definitely this union will be on epsilon closure of epsilon closure of 2 comma A union epsilon closure of 7 comma A. Okay, so this gives us epsilon closure. I'm writing CL. Okay, so 2A give and leads us to 3. So epsilon closure of 3 union 7A leads us to 8. So it is epsilon closure of 8. Correct. So epsilon closure of 3, if you see, what are the things that there? 3 itself, no, it is 3, then from 3 you can go to 6, 7, and also you can go to 1 and 2. So if I arrange them properly, then it comes 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7. Right? Union epsilon closure of 8 will give us only 8 itself. No? By giving epsilon from 8, we can't go anywhere. We can only stay on 8. Okay? So the result becomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, and 8. Okay? This. So we give this set a name B. Okay, and put here B. Next, what we have to find out, delta A, input is B here. So we have to find out in B, sorry, in A, this set, which states are having some transition for input B. We will find only 4 is having some transition, right? So our result will be epsilon closure of delta 4B, okay, which gives us epsilon closure 4B means 4 giving B, it is going to 5. So epsilon closure of 5. Epsilon closure of 5 gives us 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 4. Right? So 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is it 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 4? So is this a new set? Yes, this is another new set we got here. We give a name C. Okay, so it is leading you to C. Okay, now we have to find out what happens for B. Again, we have to start and calculate डेल्टा बी ए. सो द बी सेट व्हिच स्टेट्स आर हैविंग सम मूव फॉर ए. टू इज हैविंग अ मूव फॉर ए एंड सेवन इज हैविंग अ मूव फॉर ए. सो द कैलकुलेशन वी हैव टू डू इज epsilon closure delta of 2 comma a union epsilon closure of delta 7 comma a. That means equivalent to epsilon closure delta 2 a. That means this transition leads us to step 3. Union delta 7a, this transition leads us to state 8. So it is union epsilon closure of state 8. So this calculation we already have done here. This is epsilon closure of 3. This is epsilon closure of 8. So result will be this set, which is B. Okay. So B here. Now delta B, you give D as input. So in set D, in this set, not only. 4 is having some transition for B and 8 is also having some transition for B, correct? So our calculation will be epsilon closure of delta 4B union epsilon closure of delta 7 comma B, right? So 4b will lead us to epsilon closure. Delta 4b gives us 5 union. Delta 7b gives us, not 7, sorry, 8, right? 8 had the transition for b, so it is 8. So 8b gives us epsilon closure of delta 8b, which is leading to 9, correct? So epsilon closure of 5, we have to find out epsilon closure of 5 we calculated previously. Yes, here we have, that is C, right? So it is going to give us 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, and 7, and union with epsilon closure of 9, which is 9 itself. Okay, so this is another new set you found here, and you can name it as D. Okay, so D came here. Now we have a new state C. Keep C here and you first calculate delta C small a. So go to C. In C, 2 is having a transition for A and 7 is having a transition for A. So we know if this is the situation, the result is going to be B only. Okay. Okay. And on the other hand, we have to again calculate delta C B. So what is C here? We have C here, this set. So in C, only 4 is having some transition for B, right? So if this is the situation, it is epsilon closure of 5 is going to be the result. So epsilon closure of 5 we have calculated Somewhere. Just a minute. This is C, and C only four is having. So epsilon closure of five, and epsilon closure of five is C itself, right? So C itself. Okay. Now bring D here. On D, if you give A as input, then look at D. Where is D? We have D here, right? So which members in D are having transition for A? 2 is having transition for A, 7 is having transition for A, no other. So we know what is going to be the result. Result will be B itself, B. And on D, if you give B input, then again go to D. Who are having transition for B? You can see 4 is having transition for B and 9 is having transition for B. Okay, so epsilon closure 4, we already know what is epsilon closure 4, right? Epsilon closure 4 is going to give us 4 its. Just a minute, no. Epsilon closure of 4 comma, no, delta 4 comma B, which is epsilon closure of 5. So it is going to be give you epsilon closure of 5 union epsilon closure of, you know, this 9 is leading to 10. So 10. Okay, so epsilon closure of 5 will give us 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 4. So 1, 2, 4, and 5, 6, 7. Okay, and union epsilon closure of 10. So 10 is 10 itself. Okay, so we can give a name to this, which is E. So if E here, now we have to find out delta E comma A. So in E, you can see this 2 is having a transition for A and 7 is having a transition for A. So the result is going to be B again. So B, okay, sorry, E I had not written here. So and delta E comma B, if you see in E, this four is having transition for B and no other member is having transition for B. Okay, so it is epsilon closure of 5, right? So epsilon closure of 5 we had calculated somewhere here. It is C. Okay, so C. So this is our transition diagram, sorry, transition table we have created, and this is this transition table. If you just draw as a diagram, it will give you the DFA. Just remove them and let's draw the transition table. Let's draw the diagram, transition diagram for the transition table we have created. Okay, so create the first state A, and we can see in A this zero is involved, right? So A is going to be the initial state because A holds the initial state of the NFA. Okay, now on A, if we give small a as input, it is leading us to B, and if we give D small b as input, then it is leading us to C. Okay, now at B, if we give A as input, it is having a self loop for it, and if we give B as input, it is leading us to D. Okay, it is leading us to D. Now from C, if you give A as input, it is leading you to B. Okay, and if you give B as input, it is having a self loop for C itself. Then go to D. On D, if you give A as input, it is leading you to B, and if you give B input, then it is taking you to some other state E. Okay, on E, if you give A, it's taking you to B, and if you give B input, then it is taking you to C. Okay, so this is our DFA. What is left into it? We have to assign the final state. So out of this, if you see, what was the final state? 10. 10 was the final state in the NFA. So if you see that E state is having this member 10. So here, this E will become the final state. Okay. So clear how to convert your NFA to DFA.